Supervisor Adams. The power's been off three nights in a row. I don't care if it was on in the rest of the city, it wasn't on here. No, I don't want to talk to your supervisor. I've talked to three different supervisors already. I just want them to send a guy out here with a wrench. No, don't put me on hold, please, for God's sake. No, no, hello, hello.
Benson, would you know?
Shh. Oh, hello. Who am I talking to now? Supervisor Kingsley. Yes, well, perhaps you can help me. There's no power in the governor's mansion. That's not funny, Turkey. How'd you like to try to run the state? You can't even get the power to stay on. What about you? I'd appreciate it. Thank you.
Excuse me.
Am I in your way?
No, that's all right. The governor's misplaced his dedication speech for Delaney Park. Any idea where it might be?
Well, it's not where it should be.
Look who I'm asking, a man who wears pajamas to work.
Well, I overslept. My alarm didn't go off because the power went out again last night.
Yeah, but some of us get up with the sun. After all, the early bird gets the worm.
Well, if the early bird saw you, he'd lose his appetite.
Where is it?
I don't know. I can't find it.
Are you looking for it, too?
Yeah, do you have any idea where it might be?
Search me.
No, thanks.
The governor said he left it in his room.
My teapot?
No, the governor's speech.
The governor's speech is missing, too?
Good morning.
Morning. Miss Cross, what's that?
Don't give her any hints. See if she can get it by herself.
Thank you, Katie.
Aren't you just a little curious where Katie might have found that?
Oh, I'm sure there's some logical explanation.
I found it on the floor just outside my door.
There, you see.
You didn't happen to find a speech with the teapot, did you?
No, sorry.
It will turn on.
This is it. The governor's speech is in the cupboard.
Great filing system. You work it out by yourself?
Well, I'll see you later. I've got to get to school.
What's your hurry? You're over 2 hours late already.
I know, but if I don't hustle, I'll miss recess.
I'd sure like to know what this speech was doing in the cupboard.
I'd sure like to know when they're going to get the power fixed.
Please, can't you just leave well enough alone?
Are you talking to me?
Benson, I have some vacation time coming. I need to get away for a while.
I'd love to see you get away forever, but you'll have to wait. We've got too much work to do.
Where are you planning to go?
I don't know. Anywhere but here.
Miss Crass, is there something wrong?
No, nothing.
Are you sure? Come on, Miss Crass, what is it?
My lips are sealed.
Promises, promises.
It's nothing, nothing at all.
Benson.
Hmm?
Don't you think there's something very strange here?
Not anymore. It just left.
I hear you.
Late again. Why can't they get a crew out here to fix the power?
They don't have a crew, just supervisors. This state's got more freeloaders than a freight train.
I think it has something to do with those crows that perch outside on the wires.
Crows?
Yeah. You know, the way they grip the lines with their little feet. Well, I have never been able to understand how they keep from tipping over. I've watched them for hours.
Must be fun.
Have you ever wondered about that?
Never.
I'm sorry, Governor. I looked through that cupboard twice. I can't find the last page of the speech anywhere.
Well, all I know is I left it on my night table. So how on earth did it get into the cupboard?
Oh, you probably went down to the kitchen last night for some warm milk.
That's right. I probably did. Well, wouldn't I remember that?
Not necessarily.
Well, there were just a few lines on that last page. Maybe we can just think of what they were.
Well, I think it's just the usual sort of thing.
And so, my friends, in conclusion, this memorial park is to honor Governor Delaney.
And all his wonderful achievements, blah, 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 blah.
I've heard that speech before.
I think I can remember the rest, Governor.
Governor, here is today's agenda. Forget the first two appointments. You've already slept through them. Benson, this power problem is still with us. Can't you do something about it?
You're still with us, and I can't do anything about you.
I would like to have it fixed.
I'd like to have you fixed.
Voila.
Oh, thank you, Martha. Oh, that's funny. I don't remember saying that.
May I see that? Oh, Governor, how many times have I asked you not to end the speech with a poem? You already have that boring story about your wisdom teeth in there.
Poem.
Once upon a midnight dreary, while I pondered weak and weary over many a quaint and curious volume of forgotten lore.
It said your Allan Poe's the Raven.
The Raven? You see those crows again.
I didn't write that.
Of course not. Poe did.
No, I mean, that isn't what I typed. How could that happen?
Carelessness?
I know what I typed, and it certainly wasn't this.
Sure, it just typed itself.
Oh, I don't think that's possible. But there is something very bizarre here.
Miss Krause.
Oh, you can't get much more bizarre than that.
No, Benson. The teapot, the speech in the cupboard, the power going off, and now this. Now, there's got to be a connection, and I'll bet you Miss Krause knows what it is.
Oh, come on, Marcy. It's all a coincidence.
No, I've heard of people having experiences like this.
Yeah, but fortunately, most of them are under a doctor's care.
You wish to see me?
Yes, come in, Miss Cross. Please, sit down. Make yourself comfortable.
Thank you.
Come on, Miss Krause, let's have it.
Have what?
You know.
I do not.
Oh, come on. I can tell when somebody's hiding something. I wasn't born yesterday.
You could have fooled me.
What am I accused of?
Oh, we're not accusing you of anything, Miss Krause. It's just that Marcy here seemed to feel that there was something that you said, well, actually something that you didn't say about a certain matter that you said you didn't know anything about that would explain to me how... what is it we're asking her?
Miss Krass, it's about all these things that have been going on in the house.
I know nothing.
Miss Krause, we don't have all day to spend with this. Whatever it is you can't say, say it and let's get on with it.
You all think that I am a lunatic.
In that case, you've got nothing to lose.
Come on, Miss Krause, now what is it?
A ghost.
A ghost?
A ghost.
A ghost?
Get out of here.
You doubt the existence of things you cannot explain?
Not since I met you.
Is this ghost a personal friend or just a casual acquaintance?
May I go now?
You're already gone. And that goes for the rest of us standing here listening to this stuff.
Now, Miss Krause, what do you know about this ghost?
Well, since the time of Governor Hartwig, the story has been passed down by the people who have worked here. It was over 100 years ago that Governor Hartwig was murdered. Right here in this very house.
Taylor, act your age.
He is.
In other words, you're saying that Governor Hartwig's ghost is what's causing all this.
Oh, it's him, all right. This has happened before. It would seem his ghost is destined to walk these halls forever.
Oh, I think I'd rather leave when my term is up.
The voters might like that, too.
How was Governor Hartwig murdered?
Rumor has it he was poisoned by an ambitious aide.
Well, it makes sense to me. 100-year-old ghost is rattling around here trying to get revenge by hiding the teapot.
Und the speech, und the electricity.
And don't forget the poem.
And who knows what will be next?
Well, I suppose we could put an end to all this conjecture by just calling in an expert, having him check it out.
Governor, you call in an expert on ghosts and the public finds out about this, you might as well leave in the taxi that brings them.
Well, I guess we'll just have to live with it.
Why not? It doesn't take up much room.
In the past, his pranks have stopped after a couple of days, usually.
Well, if this were to be true, why has Hartwig stayed here for over 100 years?
Well, maybe he promised to stick around until he balanced the budget. Come on, Taylor, that ain't funny.
Losing your sense of humor?
Losing your will to live? So I did. What do you got here? The evil and the awful. The green hand oozed out of the purple slime. They're right. This is evil and awful. Whatever happened to Cinderella?
That's kid stuff. I want to be scared. Oh, boy. Maybe it's a ghost. Do you think we'll see him?
I don't think so, Katie.
Oh, there you are, Katie. Oh, I was worried about you. Were you frightened, you poor thing? You're trembling.
I'm not the one who's trembling.
Maybe you better sit down.
Stop that! I meant that I wish whatever was causing those lights to go out would stop it.
Yeah. You see? Now what do you think? He is really upset this time.
Oh, boy!
Oh, come on, everybody. They'll come back on in a minute. Haven't you ever heard of knocking?
I was afraid something would knock back.
The only thing knocking around here is people's knees. Perfectly logical explanation for everything that's going on in this mansion.
Oh, yeah? And how do you explain that?
I'm thinking. Better?
I'm fine, Benson. I'm just fine.
Just fine? Well, what was that in there?
Oh, that was just stark terror.
Well, Katie's all tucked in. She wanted me to leave some milk and cookies for the ghost, but I told her there was no such thing as a ghost.
That must have disappointed her.
Yes, but it made me feel better.
It's only me, Taylor. I'm about to come into the room.
I am in the room now, so don't anybody panic. And this, my friends, is a nail. A bent nail, to be precise. You see, the vibrations from the thunder cause the picture to separate from the bent nail.
Oh, that explains it.
No, it doesn't.
Too bad. I went to the Hall of Records this morning and learned a very interesting fact. After Hartwig was murdered, his wife married Governor Delaney.
So?
So? I'm not so sure the aide poisoned Hartwig.
Well, who did?
Governor Hartwig's ghost just told us.
I guess I wasn't listening.
Don't ask me to repeat it. Of all the pictures in the room, the one that fell was Governor Delaney's.
Fiendishly clever, Inspector! I dare say you had us all completely baffled. But once again, your piercing eye and your razor-sharp mind, not to mention that disarming smile, have uncovered the truth. Bravo, Inspector! Now, can we all go beddy-bye?
So, do you think that Delaney killed Hartwig for his office and his wife?
He killed for the office. The wife came with the furniture.
No, he must have killed for the wife. Nobody'd kill for this job. But what I don't understand is why Hartwig's taking it out on us.
Governor?
Just for the sake of argument.
There is a way to find out.
What's that?
Ask him.
Ask who? The ghost?
I'm telling you, there is a way to communicate with the dead.
You mean a seance?
Exactly.
Absolutely not.
Hear me out.
I'd rather throw you out. Look, nothing's happened. A picture fell from the wall, that's all.
What have we got to lose by trying it?
I admit it seems a little silly to me, too, but if you all are willing, I'll go along with it. What do you say, Benson?
Well, let me put it this way. Are you all out of your cotton-picking minds? Do you know what you're saying? You're asking me if I want to talk to a ghost.
How do you talk to a ghost?
I can explain it. Listen to this. Oh,
come on, Benson, let's try it.
Oh, for crying out loud, Marcy. Aren't you coming, Taylor?
Of course not. And you should all be ashamed of yourselves. Oh, all right.
Over left hand. With each other.
Sorry.
In order for this to work, we must maintain complete silence. Do not be surprised if I go into a trance.
How will we know if you do?
My head will drop forward. My tongue will hang out. My eyes will roll wildly, and I will speak in a strange voice.
Right, and how will we know when you go into a trance?
If you are all through, I will begin. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Not you, Governor.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Shall we try again? I am speaking to the spirit of Governor Hartwig. Are you upset?
We know he's upset.
You didn't believe in this.
I do. But if we're going to ask questions, ask him something we don't know the answers to.
Ask him what Xerox is going to do.
Will not answer unless we take this seriously. Someone go and shut the window.
Benson, shut the window.
Taylor, shut your face.
All right, leave it. Shh. I feel he is very close. Spirit of Governor Hartwig, were you poisoned by Governor Delaney?
That's kind of ambiguous, Miss Krause. Let me take a crack at it. What we want to know here, Governor Hart, may I call you Roger?
Silence! I feel he is trying to get through. He is trying to get through.
He got through.
Don't answer the phone.
Why not?
Because we don't want anybody to know what we're doing.
It's a telephone, Taylor. People talk through it. They don't see through it. Good evening, Governor's Mansion. No, Taylor can't come to the phone right now. He's busy. He's holding hands with the governor.
Give me that. Hello. Oh, hi. Listen, can I call you back? We're waiting for a long-distance call.
Not me. I'm not waiting for anything. For all I care, you all can spend the rest of the evening down here with the Bat Lady.
That does it. Your total lack of cooperation has offended the ghost, and it has offended me. I am leaving.
I don't blame you. Why don't you both go haunt another house?
I think I'm gonna go too. Taylor, would you give me a ride home?
Why? Your car's here.
Under the circumstances, I'd like a little companionship.
Well, you'd be better off buying a goldfish.
I'm really disappointed. This doesn't prove anything.
Did you think it would?
I don't know exactly what I expected. I gather you don't believe in ghosts.
You gather right, sir.
Well, as it turned out, the whole thing was a total waste of time. All we did was get Miss Cross upset.
Well, in that case, it wasn't a total waste of time. Now, look, it's not as if I think you're here, but if you are here, how you doing? I tell you what you do. You come on over here and have a seat, and you and I will have a conversation, sort of man to, well, a conversation. Now, if you're trying to scare me, you are wasting your time because I've been scared by some of the best. I'm talking about a car full of guys with white sheets, and it ain't Halloween. You hear what I'm saying? Well, let us say that it is true that you're the ghost of Governor Hartwick. And let us say that it is also true that Governor Delaney did a number on you to get your wife and your job. Now, I can understand you being ticked off, but scaring these people is not gonna solve that. What is it with you anyway? Are you sore because the governor named the park after Delaney? Well, why don't you just say so? You know how to type.
Benson.
What?
Who are you talking to?
Myself.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
Oh, no, no, Governor, wait. Can we talk?
Yeah.
Don't sit there. Look, Governor, about what's been going on around here, would there be any harm in not naming the park after Delaney?
Well, I changed the sign.
Besides that?
No, I don't see any harm in it. What are you thinking, Benson?
Well, what I'm thinking is, why take the chance of naming the park after a guy who could have been a rat?
So, what would I call the park?
Well, in honor of all the governors and their contributions, why not call it Governor's Park?
The Governor's Park? Well, that has a nice ring to it. I think I will. Thank you, Benson. Good night.
Good night. Governor. Okay? Well, that's the best we can do. Now, why don't you talk this over with your people, and if that's cool, then you can go about your business, and we can go about ours. Rest in peace, Governor Hartwick. I know I'd sure like to. Good morning, Governor. Did you have a good night?
Well, I don't really know. I slept through most of it. It's the third night in a row for me.
Good. Well, I got the final report on that electrical problem.
Oh, what'd they find?
The main lead to the circuit breaker was bad, and they couldn't tell before because the insulation looked okay.
I guess we all overreacted a bit, huh?
I guess.
Oh, an electrical problem. And I was letting myself get rattled by the idea of a ghost.
Well, we're only human. We all have our fears.
Oh, well, that's true. Would you believe I'm still a little afraid of me being the governor?
I think we all are.
Well, now that we know what the problem is, I guess we can name that park anything we want to.
Then again, maybe not.
Benson is videotaped before a studio audience.